The last season of Sherlock was a fantastic benchmark for British television. What are you most proud of, though, looking back on the series now it's over?
I think that we got away with not quite explaining how he faked his death, which that was a really huge challenge, because when we pushed him off the building, we obviously knew it was going to cause some interest. We had absolutely no idea it would become an international talking point for 2 years. So we knew we couldn't just sort of explain it, because it would just be a bit like, oh. So actually coming up with the idea of fake versions, and then sort of not quite saying how it's done, I'm very relieved, really.
Talking about cliffhangers, obviously Andrew's cameo at the end of the series really has people talking again.
Did you
obviously planned that. Do you plan to have more of Andrew in the next series to satisfy people?
Well, you'll have to see, won't you? You'll have to wait and see. I mean, we have to explain it, of course we do. It's clearly he shot himself in the head, so I don't know. We've done it again, haven't we?
And what else are you working on at the moment now?
I'm filming Wolf Hall for the BBC, and then I'm doing Map and Lucia, doing those concurrently all through the summer. And then I don't know.
I mean, just bring it back to Sherlock very quickly. I mean, obviously, you're very responsible behind the camera, but on screen, you're a lot of fun as well, and you and Benedict have this wonderful tension. Can you talk a little bit about working with him and the kind of bickering, lovely rivalry that Mycroft and Sherlock have?
Well, it's so much fun to do, and the idea of Mycroft is actually cleverer than his brother. We've sort of worked on the idea that, of course, Sherlock really resents that, and luckily, we never really have to explain it, because it's hard enough to make Sherlock clever, never mind Mycroft. But yeah, we have a great time, and we're very much looking forward to doing some more.
I'm curious, I mean, on the subject of Sherlock, obviously, the series took him to a very dark place, and it was lighter at the start and then really crescendoed with that. I'm curious, do you think that's going to change people's perception of Sherlock when he comes back? He's always never quite been one of the angels, but now he really is a little bit further into the shadow.
Yeah, I mean, it was a deliberate thing. We started light because we knew where we were going was going to be very dark. And I think, you know, you've just got to keep reminding yourself that Sherlock Holmes is becoming more human, but he's never going to be quite one of us. And that's, to a greater or lesser extent, that's where we'll always find him. You know, even in the original stories, by the end, he and Dr. Watson are inseparable friends, but you'd never say he was like anybody else, you know. It's by tiny degrees, really.
You got a message for fans before you leave us?
Thanks for watching. And Sherlock fans, we are moving closer to agreeing dates for the next series.